great is our God. We worship you. We adore you. We exalt you. We magnify your holy name, Father. Thank you so much for everything that you have done. Lord, you are worthy to be praised. You are worthy of all glory. Lord, you deserve it all. Who is like unto you, O God? What a privilege, what a honor to come into your presence where there is fullness of joy, where there are pleasures forevermore. What a privilege to serve a true and living God, the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the God of the gospel of Jesus. We worship you, O God of heaven. Blessed be your name, O God. Thank you so much. You are God. You are faithful. You are merciful. You are kind. Lord, thank you for all that you have done. Thank you, Father, for your mercies. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your kindness. Oh God, we are grateful, oh Lord. We are thankful, oh Lord. You deserve all the glory and all the praise. Father, I say, blessed be your name, oh God. You are worthy to be praised. Father, thank you for this opportunity to come into your presence. Thank you for what you are about to do in our lives. Thank you for saving us, for delivering us from hell. Thank you, Father. We worship you, Father. We come into your presence to lift you up. Jesus, you are glorified. Jesus, you are magnified. Jesus, you are exalted. Jesus, you are extolled. Jesus, there is no God like unto you. Jesus, you are the best. Jesus, you are the greatest. Jesus, you are the mightiest. Jesus, you are awesome. Jesus, I say, blessed be your name forever and ever. Oh, Jesus, there is no God like unto you, Father. We worship you in the beauty of your holiness. We thank you for everything that you have done. A million tongues will never be sufficient. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. What a glorious God. Ah, what a merciful God we serve. Thank you, Father, for all that you do. Thank you, Father, for always being there, for being faithful. Thank you, Father, for everything. We say, blessed be your name, O God. We worship you. Jesus, we worship you. We worship you in the beauty of your holiness. Oh, yes, Lord. I will wait on you, Almighty God, in the beauty of your holiness. I will worship you, Almighty God, in the beauty of your holiness. I will wait on you, Almighty God, in the beauty of your holiness. I will worship you, Almighty God, in the beauty of your holiness. Lord, the thirst for you, and I long to be in your presence. My soul will wait on you. Father, draw me nearer. Draw me nearer to the beauty of your holiness. I will wait on you, Almighty God, in the beauty of your holiness. I will worship you, Almighty God, in the beauty of your holiness. in the beauty of your holiness. Father, we are grateful and thankful unto you. We worship you that we can serve you. We can appreciate you for all that you have done. We bless your holy name for bringing us into this anointing and holy communion service. You are the only reason why we are here. We desperately need you. Thank you, Father. We give you all the praise and all the glory. We come today to the throne of grace to obtain mercy and find grace in the time of need. We are asking for mercy, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Have mercy on every one of us, O God. Have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Have mercy on our souls. Have mercy on us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your mercy prevail, O God. Let your mercy prevail in our lives. Whatever we have done that will prevent you from moving today, let your mercy prevail in the mighty name of Jesus. Anything we have done that will prevent us from going to heaven, let your mercy prevail in the mighty name of Jesus. Anything we have done that we are doing or we are going to do that will make us miss rapture, let your mercy prevail in the name of Jesus. Lord, anything that will prevent you from moving in our lives today, let your mercy prevail in the mighty name of Jesus. We are asking for your mercy, O God. We pray for your mercy, that it will prevail in our midst today, in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus, thou Son of David, have mercy on us. Have mercy on us, O God. Let your mercy prevail. We come to the throne of grace to obtain mercy and find grace in the time of need. We have come to the throne of grace. We have come to the throne of grace, O God. We've come to the throne of grace to obtain mercy. Father, we are calling on the God of mercy, Jesus. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on our souls today. In the mighty name of Jesus, let your mercy prevail. Let your mercy prevail. Forgive us whatever it is that we have done. Whatever evil that will prevent your move in our life, that will prevent you from touching us today. Father, we are pleading your mercy in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your mercy prevail in every area of our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. I want everybody to talk to God. I want you to talk to God. Ask God to touch you. Ask God to touch you. Ask God to touch you. Ask him that, Lord, I need a touch from you. Lord, I need a touch from you. Lord, touch me, Lord. Touch me. Father, touch me. I need a touch. A divine touch, a supernatural touch. I'm asking that you will touch me, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Touch me, Father. Ask God. Oh, there is a touch you need, a life-changing touch, a life-transforming touch. Ask God to touch you. Only God can touch you like no man. Only God's touch can change your life forever. Only God's touch can change your life for good. But you have to ask God to touch you. Ask him that, Lord, touch me in the mighty name of Jesus. Tell God that you don't want to live today's service the same way. You don't want to live today's service the same way. Now you need a touch from heaven. You need divine touch. You need supernatural touch. Now, Lord, I have come into your presence that you might touch me. That you might touch me, Lord, in the name of Jesus. I have come to have an encounter with Jesus. I have come to have an encounter with Jesus. Lord, touch me, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm asking for a touch from you, a touch from heaven. That, Lord, you will touch me like never before. Touch me, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Ah, Lord, touch me. Change my life today, Father. Change my life. Change my destiny. Change me completely today, Father. Let my life not remain the same again. I need somebody to talk to God. I need somebody to talk to God. Tell God yourself. Tell God that you need a touch from him. Tell God that you need a visitation from him. Tell God that you need an encounter from him. Tell God, God is here. Bible says where two or more are gathered in his name, he is there in their midst. Bible says The gathering of his people is unto him. He has not told the house of Jacob to seek him in vain. Brethren, ask God. The Lord is here. Ask him that, Lord, you have to be genuine concerning your request. God sees your heart. He knows whether you are genuine. Don't be distracted. Don't be distracted. Just focus on Jesus at this time. Focus on the Lord. Let your attention be on the Lord. Let your attention be on the Lord. Don't be distracted at all. Tell God, Lord, I need a touch from you. Lord, I need an encounter from you. Lord, I need a visitation from you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. When God touches you, it turns your life the right way up. When God touches you, things begin to move in your life. When God touches you, you will begin to experience favor. When God touches you, everything begins to work. Things that never used to work, the areas of your struggle will become ease for you when God touches you. Ask God for that touch. Ask God for a touch, divine touch, supernatural touch. Oh, ask God for that touch. When the Lord touches you, the pain you used to feel, you will feel them no more. Ask God, the Lord, touch me. In the mighty name of Jesus, touch me, Lord. Oh, touch me, Lord. I need a touch from you, oh God. I want you to touch me, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, I want you to touch me, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, touch me, oh God. In the precious name of Jesus, touch me, Father. Touch me, Lord. Touch me, touch me. Touch me, touch me, touch me. Touch me, Lord. Lord, we need a touch from you, Father. We need a divine touch. We need supernatural touch. Oh, Lord, touch us. We don't want to leave today's service the same way. We need an encounter. We need a unique touch from you, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, touch us. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus, touch us. In the mighty name of Jesus, touch me with your hands. Jesus, touch me with your hands. With Jesus, touch me with your hands. Jesus, touch me with your hands. Jesus, Lord, don't let me go the same way I came. Touch me with your hands. Jesus, Lord, don't let me go the same way I came. Touch me with your hands. Jesus, 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 Lord, don't let me go the same way I came. Touch me with your hands. Jesus, Lord, we desperately need a touch from you. We need a life-changing touch. We need you to touch us, oh God, in such a way that our lives will never be the same again. Lord, touch us forever, Father. We need an eternal touch today, oh God. We need a memorable touch today, a touch that we will remember for the rest of our lives. Jesus, we are asking, oh Lord, that you will touch us. We are here because of you, Lord. We know that only you can touch us in such a way that we will never recover from. We are asking for that touch, oh God, that heavenly touch, that divine touch, that supernatural touch, that healing touch, oh God. Touch us, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Touch us today, Father. Touch us with your hand, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, let our lives not be the same again, Father. We ask, oh God, for that touch in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Hallelujah. Today, God wants to anoint us. God wants to pour His Spirit upon us. God wants to touch us in such a way that we will never recover from. God wants to use us mightily. He wants to use us gloriously. God wants to set us aside for His purpose and for His plan. God wants to put His Spirit upon us. God wants to pour His Spirit upon us, and God wants to shield us. God wants to protect us as His own as we take the Holy Communion. God wants to do something. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that today will be a memorable service in Jesus' name. Today will be a service that we will never recover from in the mighty name of Jesus. That what God will do today, we will remember it in 10 years in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, that our lives will never be the same again. God is going to break yokes. The Lord is going to deliver people. He's going to set the captives free. God is going to do things that only God can do in our midst. In the mighty name of Jesus. I want us to ask God that in the mighty name of God, so shall it be in our lives in Jesus' name. When God anoints, the anointing is the release of the power and the Spirit of God on a person to enable them to do what they ordinarily would have been unable to do themselves. That is what the anointing is for. So when God anoints you, God gives you the empowerment. He pours out His Spirit upon you, and you begin to do things that ordinarily you wouldn't have been able to do yourself. That is what happens when God anoints you. As human beings, we are limited. We are very, very limited. We are limited on what we can do. But when God's Spirit comes upon you, you begin to do the supernatural. You begin to do the incredible. You begin to do things beyond human comprehension. When God anoints us, the anointing is the release of the power and the Spirit of God on a person to enable them to do what they ordinarily would have been unable to do by themselves. That is what the anointing is for. The anointing enables you, empowers you, gives you the supernatural grace of God to be able to walk in the supernatural. And that is what we are asking God for today. That Lord, anoint us. Pour your Spirit upon us. Pour that Spirit upon us in the mighty name of Jesus. Bible says in Acts chapter 2, verse 17 to 18. Acts of Apostles chapter 2, verse 17 to 18. It says, "And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh." God is saying He's going to pour out His Spirit upon all flesh. "And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. And your young men shall see vision. And your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servant and on my handmaiden, I will pour out in those days my Spirit, and they shall prophesy." And they shall prophesy. When that is what happens when the Spirit of God comes upon us. When the anointing of the Holy Ghost rests upon us. Those are the type of things that will happen. That we will begin to see visions. We will begin to prophesy. We will begin to do the supernatural by the grace of God. That's what we are praying for. The Lord, pour out your Spirit. We are tired of doing things in the flesh. We are tired of doing things by ourselves. Lord, we need supernatural help. We need divine intervention. And that is when God now pours out. God empowers us. God enables us to be able to do things that ordinarily we have been struggling with. God enables us to do such things. Areas of our struggle, we begin to sweatlessly triumph. Areas where we have difficulties, we begin to move with ease. Areas that we have challenges, things just begin to work because of the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Because of the anointing of the Holy Ghost. That is why we need God's anointing. We need God's touch in the mighty name of Jesus. We need God's touch. What are the reasons why would God anoint you?
What is the purpose of the anointing? Why will God anoint us? Usually, the anointing is the making of a person or an object with oil. The anointing is the marking of a person or an object with oil to establish the person or thing for a special purpose. When God anoints somebody, God just does not pour His Spirit upon everyone. First of all, you have to be saved for God to pour His Spirit upon you. Because the Spirit of God is the Spirit of holiness. You have to be saved for God to pour His Spirit upon you. The Spirit of God is always grieved when we sin, when we commit iniquity. So it is the Spirit of holiness. So when God pours His anointing upon a person or an object, it is because God is separating that thing for a special purpose. God has a specific purpose for that person. It's not just for our own selfish use. It's not for our selfish use. It's for the glorification of His kingdom. Because God has a divine plan for you. He has a divine purpose for you. And that is why God will pour out His Spirit upon you. The anointing is the marking of a person or object with oil. With oil. So it's not just person that God anoints. God anoints the altar. God anoints things too. Just to say that this is mine. This has been consecrated as mine. But God mostly anoints people. So it's the marking of a person or an object with oil. Why is it oil? That's just the means and the medium that God has chosen to establish the person or thing for a special purpose. For a special purpose. In the Old Testament, God anointed a lot of priests just to say that they belong to God. For the strict purpose of worshiping, but they belong to God. So God anoints. It is God that anoints. The anointing comes from God. The anointing comes from God. So the oil is just a medium that God uses. But the anointing actually comes from God. He pours out His Spirit upon people. God pours out His Spirit upon people, and the anointing comes from the Almighty God. Hallelujah. Let's see some purposes, some of the reasons why God we anoint. What are the reasons why do we need the anointing of the Holy Ghost? Why do we need God to anoint us? What is the reason? Can we just do without the anointing, or do we really need this anointing? Do we need God to pour out His Spirit upon us? Do we need God to anoint us? What is the reason why God will anoint us? Let's see some of those reasons. Reason number one. When we are anointed with the Holy Ghost, it teaches us everything. The Holy Ghost will teach us everything. Look at John chapter 2, 27. But the anointing that you receive from Him abides in you. The anointing abides in you that you receive from Him, that is from God, abides in you, and you have no need that anyone should teach you. But as His anointing teaches you about everything, God knows everything. So imagine God puts His Spirit upon you, and His Spirit begins to teach you everything because you have been anointed. So there's nothing as good as that. For you to know everything, because God knows everything, and He puts the Spirit upon you, and the Spirit teaches you everything. Bible says, but as His anointing teaches you about everything, and is true, and is no lie, just as it has taught you, abide in Him. That's the Spirit of truth. The Spirit that will tell you the wrong from the right. The Spirit that will guide you. It teaches you everything. When you are confused, it tells you what to do. When you need direction, it leads you. It shows you exactly how you need to raise your children. It shows you how you need to deal with your husband. When you are anointed, that is what the Spirit of God does. It tells you when to calm down. It tells you when not to fight. It teaches you everything. We need such an anointing. We need such spirit to be able to go through life. Because we are always finding ourselves in situations whereby we need help. We are confused. We need direction. We don't know what to do. We can't handle a particular situation. But here is the anointing of the Holy Ghost, the Spirit of God. Bible says, but as his anointing teaches you about everything, not most things, not 99% of things, but everything. That's why we need the anointing of the Holy Spirit. That's why we need God to anoint us. Hallelujah. The anointing is another reason why, or reason number two, why God anoints us is to preach, to heal, to deliver, and to set free. God puts his spirit upon us for such a purpose. A lot of people are out there, they need deliverance from the dominion of darkness. They need healing. They have been held bound by the enemy. And because we are in a spiritual world, because we are in a because this world is spiritual, but we physically are, we are physical, but because they are held bound by the things of the spirit, we can't help them. We cannot deliver them, because this is not a situation whereby somebody is stuck in a place that we have to call firefighter to come and rescue the person. This is not that type of situation. This is a situation whereby somebody is held bound. This is a situation whereby the devil has had covenant with people that they will never have it. They will never have children. They will never get married. That their destiny, their stars has been stolen by the devil. They are in the bondage of the enemy. They have been held captive. Though we physically cannot help them. We can't help them. And so, Bible says in Luke 4:18. Why do we need the anointing? Luke 4:18. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. The ability to be able to tell, to preach the gospel to the unchurched and the unsaved. God has anointed us. We need the anointing for such things. To be able to act. To be able to preach the gospel adequately. We need such anointing, brethren. So Bible says, he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted. To preach deliverance to the captives and the recovery of sight to the blind and to set at liberty them that are bruised. Do you see the choice of what the Bible is using? Deliverance. Bible says deliverance. Bible says recovery. Bible says liberty. Do you see what the Bible says? This is the reason why we need anointing. Because people need deliverance. People need recovery. People need liberty. Why? Because the devil has held them bound. The devil has held them captive. And only the anointing of the Holy Ghost can set the people free. Only the anointing of the Holy Ghost. And so it's when we are anointed that we have the power of the Almighty to be able to set those people free. In the name of Jesus. Bible says in Acts 10:38, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. God anointed Jesus with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil. Jesus went about doing good. Everyone that was oppressed of the devil, he was setting them free. How was he able to do that? God anointed him. God anointed him. That was how he was able to do that. God poured his spirit and his anointing upon him. And that was how Jesus was able to do that. Bible says, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. He went about healing people. He went about delivering people. How was he able to do that? God's anointing. It's because God anointed Jesus. God anointed Jesus. So we need anointing. We need the anointing of the Holy Ghost to be delivered from the oppression of the enemy, or for the people to be delivered from the hands of the enemy. We need the anointing of the Holy Ghost for that. So another reason why we need the anointing of the Holy Ghost, another reason is healing from sickness and diseases. Healing from sickness and diseases. Bible says in Mark 6:13, and they cast out many devils. They cast out many devils and anointed with oil many that were sick and healed them. Today, by the grace of God, if you are sick today, today is your day of healing. Today is the day you will be delivered from that sickness. Today is the day the Lord will break that yoke of sickness. Bible says, and they cast out many devils, Mark 6:13, and anointed with oil many that were sick and healed them. That is what he did. They anointed all the people that were sick and they began to heal them. I want you to have confidence in the word of God, that this is the word of God. That as we anoint ourselves today, that in the mighty name of Jesus, every sickness, every disease shall be healed in the name of Jesus. Everyone that the devil has held bound shall be released in the mighty name of Jesus. Every yoke of the devil shall be shattered in the mighty name of Jesus. Bible says in James 5:14, is anyone among you sick? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. Bible says, is anyone sick? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. So we can see what the Bible says. And Bible now says that the prayer of faith will heal the sick. We can see what the Bible says, that when we believe God and we pour his anointing upon the person that is sick, Bible says that that person will be delivered from that sickness. That person will be set free from that sickness. So we need the anointing to be healed from sickness. God uses the anointing so that we are healed. We are healed from any form of sickness and disease. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The anointing of the Holy Ghost. Why do we need the anointing? Sanctification, to set us apart. If God is going to use you, God has to equip you. If God is going to use you, God has to equip you. Because if you are enrolled in the army of God as a believer, you are going to be fighting against invisible enemies. So God will not just send you to go and fight without equipping you. So God has to set you aside. Bible says in Leviticus 8:10, Bible says, and Moses took the anointing oil and and anointed the tabernacle and all that was therein, and sanctified them. And he sprinkled thereof upon the altar 7 times, and anointed the altar and all the vessel, both the laver and his foot, to sanctify them. And poured of the anointing oil upon Aaron's head, and anointed him and sanctified him. He poured the anointing upon Aaron's head, anointed Aaron, and sanctified him. Sanctified. Sanctification is to set apart for the use of God. Sanctification is to set yourself apart for God's use. So God anointed Aaron. And God says, Aaron, I have set you apart for my use. So when God anoints you, it's for a purpose. It's for a specific use. It's not just for your own selfish interest or our selfish interest. In Exodus 49. So Bible says here, then you shall take the anointing oil and anoint the tabernacle and all that is in it, and consecrate it and all its furniture, so that it may become holy. You see that? Holiness, anointing, they go hand in hand. So God anoints that person so that they will become holy. That means that you cannot continue to sin while operating under God's anointing. You cannot continue to sin while you are operating under God's anointing. That's one of the reasons. So God will set you aside. God anoints you so that you can serve him. He empowers you. He equips you to be able to serve him. Bible says in Exodus 28:41, and thou shalt put them upon Aaron thy brother and his sons with him, and shall anoint them and consecrate them and sanctify them, that they may minister unto me in the priest's office. In the priest's office. So God says that you shall anoint them and consecrate them and sanctify them, that they may minister unto me in the priest's office. That they may minister unto me, that they may do my work, that they may serve me. So if you need God's anointing, it's for service. God anoints you to be able to serve him, to be able to do the supernatural in the kingdom of God. God anoints you for such a purpose. Hallelujah. God also anoints you to protect you. God anoints you to protect you. Bible says in 1 Chronicles 16:21, he says, he allowed no one to oppress them. He rebuked kings on their account, saying, touch not my anointed one. Do my prophet no harm. So if you are anointed, God is saying, no one will be able to touch you. If you are anointed, nobody can touch you, because God is going to protect you. God is going to shield you from evil. God is going to put that touch not on your head. So when they see you, they say, we cannot touch this one. Remember what the devil told God about Job? He said, I can't touch him. I can't touch his household. I can't touch all that belongs to him. Why? Because you have protected him. You have set a hedge of protection around him. So Bible says that touch not my anointed and do my prophets no harm. So you see that it's important for us to be anointed of God, because the enemy will not be able to touch us. Because the enemy is going to see us that, oh, this is God's own. We cannot go there. We cannot go into that area. This one belongs to God. We can't touch this one. So it's very important for our children to be anointed, because we can't go with them everywhere they go. We are not with them in schools. We are not with them when they go out. So, but when there is an anointing upon their lives, the enemy will not be able to touch them. Because Bible says, touch not my anointed. My anointed ones, and do my prophets no harm. Bible says in 1 Corinthians, Bible says in 1 Corinthians 21, it says, 1 Corinthians 21, it says, now it is God who makes both us and you stand firm in Christ. So me, this one is the biggest. It is God who makes both us and you stand firm in Christ. He anointed us, set his seal of ownership on us, and put his spirit in our hearts as a deposit, guaranteeing what is to come. If God were to guarantee you that you will make it to heaven, there's nothing as good as that. That is the ultimate of everything. That is the best of the best. Heaven is eternal. And anybody that misses heaven can never miss hell. So God says he anoints us and set his seal of ownership on us. Can you imagine? The enemy can't touch you because you belong to God. That's why the Bible says, he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. You are continuously under his shadow, under his covering. Bible says, he set his seal of ownership on us, that we belong to God, and put his spirit in our hearts as a deposit, guaranteeing what is to come. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, it is God who makes both us and you stand firm in Christ. Can you imagine that God helps us to stand firm in Christ? That we will not give in, we will not give up, we will stand and stay focused in Christ. He anointed us. So for us to do that, God put his spirit upon us. He anointed us. He set his seal of ownership on us. I belong to God. I belong to Jesus. I belong to the kingdom of God by the grace of God. And he put his spirit in us, in our hearts as a deposit, guaranteeing what is to come. We need the anointing of the Holy Ghost. We need God's anointing upon our lives to set us free. We need God, and we have to ask God, our Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, anoint us, O God. Pour your spirit upon us. Pour your spirit upon us. And there are many other reasons, but let me just share just one more. Anybody that is to be a king, a prophet, a minister, a deacon, or whatsoever, God anoints them. Bible says in 2 Kings chapter 9, verse 2, Bible says, and when thou comest thither, look out there, Jehu, the son of Jehoshaphat, the son of Nimshi, and go in and make him arise up from among his brethren and carry him to an inner chamber. Then take the box of oil and pour it on his head and say, thus say the Lord, I have anointed thee king over Israel. Then open the door and flee and tarry not. And he arose and went into the house and poured the oil on his head and said unto him, thus says the Lord of Israel, I have anointed thee king over the people of the Lord, even over Israel. Hallelujah. Thus says the Lord, I have anointed you. Let's look at 1 Samuel 9:15. 1 Samuel 9:15. 1 Samuel 9:15. It says, Now the Lord had told Samuel in his ear a day before Saul came, "Tomorrow about this time I will send thee a man out of the land of Benjamin, and thou shalt anoint him to be captain over my people. Thou shalt anoint him to be captain over my people." So God gave him a responsibility. So then God anoints him to be able to do the work that God has given unto him. To be captain over my people Israel, that he may save my people out of the hand of the Philistines. For I have looked upon my people because their cry is come unto me, that he may save my people from the hands of the Philistines. Do you see why God anoints? We need the anointing of God. There are some battles that you cannot fight yourself. You need divine intervention. You need supernatural help. You need divine help. And it takes the anointing of the Holy Ghost. It takes the Spirit of God to be with you, to be able to conquer those things. It takes somebody that is anointed to be able to overcome those challenges. It takes the anointing of the Holy Ghost. And this is just God pouring out His Spirit upon you, putting His stamp upon you. God putting His hand upon your life. God touching your life. And things begin to turn the right way up. That is what the anointing of God does. So this is very, very important. This is not a man's touch. This is a touch from God. This is a divine touch. This is an heavenly touch. This is a touch that you will never recover from. A touch that tomorrow you will remember that, it was when the Lord touched me. It was when the Lord touched me that things began to get better in my life. That is the type of touch that we are talking about. And God cannot force His oil upon you. You have to desire the anointing of God. You have to desire that, "Lord, anoint me, Lord. Use me, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus." You have to talk to God. You have to talk to God that God, you need His anointing. Bible says in Isaiah 61:3. Bible says in Isaiah 61:3, it says, "To appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning. The oil of joy, the oil of joy for mourning." For those that mourn, God gives them the oil of joy. He gives them the anointing. He anoints them. Those that have been depressed, the anointing sets free. I want everybody to talk to God. I want you to speak to God. And ask God that, "Lord, I need a touch. Touch me, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Touch me, Lord. Oh, Lord, I need a touch from you, Father. I need a touch. If you have your anointing oil, I want you to open it. Because right now, this may be ordinary oil. But we are going to ask this God to put His touch upon it. Then it becomes the oil of God. It becomes the anointing oil. So, right now, what I have here says olive oil. So we are going to change this olive oil into anointing oil. So it's no longer olive oil. It becomes anointing oil. It becomes anointing oil. In the mighty name of Jesus. Because God is about to pour His Spirit. He's about to pour His oil upon us. And our lives will never be the same again. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank You. Let us pray. Let us commit this into the hands of the Lord, the Father. In the mighty name of Jesus. That this is no longer ordinary oil. This is no longer olive oil. But this is Your oil. The anointing oil. In the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus is the anointed one. Jesus is the anointed one. And because Jesus is the anointed one, this oil becomes an anointing oil. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, let Your Spirit rest upon it. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord of heaven, we ask in the name of Jesus that this oil becomes Yours. In the name of Jesus. Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. that as we use this oil and as we anoint ourselves, so God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we ask that our lives will never be the same again. That this anointing, as it touches us, it will be a touch of God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we are asking, oh God, that as this oil touches us, oh God, that yokes will be broken. Captives will be set free. In the mighty name of Jesus, there will be divine visitation, unique encounter, supernatural visitation. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are asking, oh Lord, that let there be a mighty touch. Let there be a touch from heaven, a divine and supernatural touch, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. A touch that makes us to go about doing good, healing all those that are oppressed of the enemy, because you are with us. In the mighty name of Jesus, a touch from heaven, oh Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Pour your spirit upon this oil, oh God, and make it an anointing oil. Lord, in the name of Jesus, as it touches us, our lives will never be the same again. You will change us. You will transform us in the name of Jesus. You will consecrate us unto you. You will set us apart, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. You will put that touch not my anointed upon us in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, thank you, Father. We give you the praise, oh God. We give you the glory for your oil. We give you all the adoration, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Brethren, this is the oil of God. This is the anointing oil of God, the oil of the Holy Ghost, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we are asking, in the mighty name of Jesus, as your people use the oil, Father, we ask of you that their lives will never be the same again. In the name of Jesus, we ask that you will touch every one of them, oh God. Lord, in the name of Jesus, let yokes be broken. Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord, go into their different homes, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, and begin to cover them, begin to protect them. Father, set a seal of ownership upon them according to your word, oh God. Anoint them from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. In the mighty name of Jesus, pour your spirit, pour your oil upon them. In the name of Jesus, we are asking for a fresh oil, a new oil, in the mighty name of Jesus. Touch every one of them. Touch their children. Touch their spouses. Touch that which belongs to them, in the name of Jesus. Brethren, with this oil, go and touch everything about you. Put that oil upon your children. Put the oil upon your spouse. Put the oil upon your family, and their lives will never be the same again. This is the touch of God. God is setting them aside. God is marking them as a seal. God is saying, these ones are mine. These ones belong to me. That is the reason for this oil. That is the reason for God anointing us today. In the mighty name of Jesus, ask God for that touch. I need somebody to talk to God. Ask God for that touch. Now, I don't know what area of your life, before you are anointed, I don't know what area of your life that you need divine visitation. I don't know what area of your life you need divine encounter. I don't know what area of your life that you need God. This is the time for you to ask God, in the mighty name of Jesus, that God, I need help. I need help. I need help, in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to talk to God. I want you to talk to God. Talk to God. Whatever area of your life, talk to God, in the name of Jesus. Do you need Jesus to heal you? Bible says that the anointing breaks the yoke. Do you need to be set free? Are you brokenhearted? Do you need to be delivered from one thing or the other? You've been oppressed by the enemy. You've been held captive. What is it that is in your life that you need God to set you free from? What is it that you need divine visitation? You need to talk to God, because God is here. The Spirit of God is here. The Spirit that breaks yokes. No, Bible says, it shall come to pass on that day, in the last day, on that day, that the burden shall be lifted off your shoulder and the yoke off your neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. The yoke yoke of the devil upon your life will be destroyed today because of the anointing of the Holy Ghost. The Bible says it shall come to pass on that day. Today is that day. Brethren, today is the day we are talking about. The Bible says the burden shall be lifted off your shoulder. God is going to lift the burden off your shoulder and the yoke off your neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. Brethren, every yoke of the devil is being destroyed as we anoint ourselves today in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Lord of heaven, we thank you. We give you the praise and the worship. We honor you, we adore you, we exalt you, Lord. Father, we are asking you in the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord, as we anoint ourselves, oh God, touch us, oh God, with your oil. Let it be a touch of God. Let it be a divine touch. Let it be a supernatural touch. Let it be an eternal touch. Let it be a memorable touch. Let it be a touch we will never recover from. Let it be a touch that will carry us for the rest of our life. Lord, put your touch upon us in the name of Jesus. Through this anointing, in the mighty name of Jesus, we are asking for that touch. Oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, thank you, Father, for the divine touch in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. If you have your oil with you, I just want you to just put it upon your head. Put that oil upon your head and anoint it. Anoint your head. Usually they anoint the head. Anoint the head because it's so that it can go down. So we put the anointing of the Holy Ghost. This is the anointing of the Holy Ghost. We put that anointing of God. Put it upon your head. This is a seal of God upon you. The seal of God. Put that anointing. Anoint your spouse. Anoint your children. Anoint your household. Anoint your household. Anoint every member of your family. Anoint them. You are putting a touch knot on their head, that no evil will befall them, no scourge will come near their dwelling place. That's what the anointing of the Holy Ghost does. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are still going to pray, brethren. We are still going to pray. We are still going to pray. But before we continue the prayers, I want us to take the Holy Communion at the same time. This is the body and the blood of Jesus. This is the body and the blood of Jesus. I want us to take the Holy Communion. Brethren, you know, as we are all in our homes, we are in our different homes, there was something that happened in Egypt. There was something that happened in Egypt. In Egypt, Bible says that when the spirit of death was going around to kill people, Bible says God told the Israelites to put the blood of goats, of sheep, upon the lintel of their houses. They put the blood upon the lintel of their houses. And when they put that blood upon the lintel of their houses, when the spirit of death, when it saw the blood, Bible says it passed over. And Bible says that death is the last enemy. And we are talking about the spirit. We are talking about the spirit of death. It passed over the people. We are talking about the blood of lamb, the blood of goats. We are talking about the blood of ram. How much more the everlasting blood of Jesus? Bible says we defeated the devil by the word of our testimony and by the blood of the lamb. We are talking about the same blood that was shed for the remission of our sins. The same blood that liberated us from hell. We are talking about the blood of Jesus. That is the blood we are talking about. The one that delivers us. The one that sets us free. Hallelujah. That's the blood we are talking about. The Bible says the life of the flesh is in the blood. The life of the flesh is in the blood. The life of the flesh is in the blood. people that are in hell. They don't have blood. Why didn't you have blood in hell? Because there's no life in hell. There's no life in hell. But the life of the flesh is in the blood. You are about to take the life of Christ, the blood of Christ. You are about to take the blood of Jesus. The one that breaks yokes, the one that destroys the devil. You are about to be covered with the blood of Jesus. As this pandemic goes on, you and your household, you are about to be covered with the precious blood of the Lamb. Jesus told them, the Lord told them, if you put the blood upon the lintel of your house, the spirit of death will pass over. I want to guarantee you that as you take this blood of Christ today, that nobody that belongs to you will die this year. The devil cannot take anybody that belongs to you. Because of the blood of the Lamb that we are about to take. This blood of Jesus covers you. He protects you. It is the same blood that purchased us, that snatched us from the jaw of darkness. It is the same blood that was shed. Bible says, without shedding of blood, there is no remission of sins. So Jesus shed his blood to purchase us from the enemy. We are about to take that blood. We are about to take the body of Christ. Bible says that Jesus broke his body for us. So we are about to take the body of Christ and we are about to take the blood of Jesus. Brethren, this is the body. I want you to take the bread. Take the bread. Take the bread. Take it. Bible says in the same night that he was crucified, Jesus took the bread. Bible says he broke it and he gave it to the disciples and he said to them, this is my body. Brethren, this is not bread anymore, but it is the body of Christ. And as we take the body of Christ, you become part and parcel of Christ. Jesus told the disciples, not the 12, but Jesus told the disciples that I will give you my body and I will give you my blood to eat. And they said, this is a hard saying. Who can hear this? Bible says, as from that day, they stopped following him. Bible says, now he now looked to the 12 and asked them, will you also go away? And they said, who shall we go to? You have the word of life. You are it for us. We don't have any other option. You are our only option. There's no other person to go to. There's no other person to go to. So, the body binds us. We are bonded with Christ as we take the body of Christ. That's why they call the church the body of Christ. And Bible says the gates of hell shall not prevail. Father, thank you. Jesus, we give you the praise. Jesus, we worship you. Jesus, we adore you. Jesus, we exalt you. Jesus, we magnify you. Jesus, we worship you. Jesus, we adore you. We call on that name of Jesus, the name that is above all names, as we take your body. We eat this unto life in the mighty name of Jesus. We eat your body unto life in Jesus' name. Let us eat the body of Christ. Let us eat the body of Christ in the mighty name of Jesus. Bible says that after that, he took the blood. Bible says he took the blood. And Jesus Christ said, This is my blood that was shed for the remission of your sins. He now told them, drink it all. Brethren, this is the most powerful weapon, the blood of Christ, that we defeated the devil by the blood of the Lamb, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. As this blood comes into contact with your body, I'm telling you, whatever it is, I want you to ask God for mercy. If you have any sin, any iniquity in your heart, you are holding anybody, ask God for mercy in the mighty name of Jesus. Because this blood was shed for the remission of our sins. Ask God for mercy as you are about to take this blood and ask God, that Lord, whosoever has done me wrong, I let go, I release, I set them free. Not for their sake, but for your sake, Lord, because you are asking me to do it in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your mercy prevail in the precious name of Jesus. I'm asking, oh God, in the name of Jesus. If you have any sin, any iniquity in your heart, before you take this blood, ask God for mercy in the mighty name of Jesus. Tell Jesus to forgive you. Oh, in the name of Jesus. And anyone that is not born again, you cannot even take this meal. You have to be born again to be able to take the body and the blood of Christ. Ask God for mercy. Ask God to come into your life, to save your soul, to deliver you from hell. In the mighty name of Jesus, before we take this body of Christ, ask God for mercy in the mighty name of Jesus. And Lord, as I'm about to take your blood, I drink this unto life in the mighty name of Jesus. This is the blood of Jesus. Lord, I drink this to life in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us drink the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. I want us to begin to talk to the Lord. I want us to begin to speak to Jesus. Let's begin to talk to the Lord. Now it's time for us to pray. It's time for us to pray. This is what the church is about. Pray, talk to the Lord. Tell God that I'm liberated. Tell God that I'm healed. Tell Jesus that I'm delivered. Tell him yourself. I'm not going to tell him for you. You tell him yourself. Tell him that I've been set free in the mighty name of Jesus. It was the blood and the body of Jesus that you took. So you tell him yourself that, Lord, I have taken your blood, I've taken your body. I've been anointed, oh God. So my life will not be the same again. Lord, thank you because you have set me free. You have broken that yoke upon my life. Believe God, believe your prayers. Talk to God. Talk to him yourself. Speak to Jesus yourself. Tell him yourself in the name of Jesus that so shall it be. Talk to him. Let him know in the name of Jesus. Talk to the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, tell him yourself. Talk to God, talk to God, talk to God. I need somebody to talk to God. Talk to God. Oh, Father, thank you. We give you the praise. Oh, for liberating us, for breaking that yoke of the enemy, for destroying the works of darkness in our lives, for setting us free, Lord. We give you the praise for healing our bodies. Oh, Lord, thank you. Because any growth that may be in our body that we are unaware of, they have dried to their roots in the name of Jesus. Anything that you have not planted, Lord, they are uprooted in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, anyone that is held bound, Lord, they are set free in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we ask, oh God, in the precious name of Jesus, that you will liberate them. You will set them free. In the mighty name of Jesus, we give you the praise, oh God. We worship you, Father. We bless your holy name, oh God, for your healing power over your people, Lord. Lord, I curse that spirit of sickness to its root in the name of Jesus. Father, I decree that your children are liberated in the mighty name of Jesus. That that sickness, that headache, that migraine, that pain, that arthritis, Lord, whatever has a name, in the name of Jesus, I command you to loose your grip, devil, in the name of Jesus. You have no hold over this children of God. In the mighty name of Jesus, you are set free. You are liberated. You are delivered. In the name of Jesus, every yoke of the devil is broken upon your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Ah, whatever burden you have, whatever burden will you have, Bible says it is lifted, because the word of God says it shall come to pass today that the burden shall be lifted off your shoulder and the yoke off your neck. Oh, that burden is lifted off your shoulder. You will not carry that burden anymore. In the mighty name of Jesus, that yoke is lifted off your neck. That burden is destroyed. The yoke is destroyed because of the anointing of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus, those of you that have bad dreams, you are set free. In the mighty name of Jesus, that devil that torments you in your dream, I curse it to his root. I release the fire of the Holy Ghost to consume that devil. In the mighty name of Jesus, you are liberated from the hands of the enemy. You are delivered in the mighty name of Jesus by the blood of the Lamb, by the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, anyone that is held bound by a satanic covenant, by a demonic covenant, we invoke the covenant of the blood of Jesus to break such covenant. Whatever it may come from, be it from your parents, be it from your forefathers, be it from your generation, today we invoke the covenant of the blood of Jesus upon your life, that satanic hold is broken in the name of Jesus. That repeated failure is canceled in the name of Jesus. You are set free in the mighty name of Jesus. You are liberated in the mighty name of Jesus. You are released from the dominion of darkness by the reason of the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord sets you free. Jesus heals you. Jesus delivers you. Jesus makes you whole. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, anybody that has any captivity, Bible says, when the Lord turns around the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. Today is the last day of the month. Before this month runs out, in the name of Jesus, before this month runs out, whatever captivity that you have, today it is turned around. In the name of Jesus, it will be like a dream in the night. You will feel as if you are dreaming, because the Lord turns around the captivity of Zion. The Lord sets you free. We have 7 more months to go this year. God will perfect the remainder of the year for you. God will carry you through the rest of the year. You will excel for the rest of the year concerning everything you do. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord will touch you. The Lord will change you. For the rest of the year, the Lord will be with you. God has put a touch not my anointing upon you. No evil shall be able to touch you, because the hand of the Lord is upon you. The hand of the Lord is upon you. In the mighty name of Jesus, everything will begin to go the right way up. Everything will begin to work for you for the rest of the year. Father, we give you the praise. We give you the glory. We worship you. We adore you. We bless your holy name. We say thank you, Jesus. We honor you forever and ever. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Brethren, let us for the month of June, we pray every day in the morning at 6 a.m. We are going to continue to pray by the grace of God. We are going to continue to pray every day. And also, every Wednesday, we have our midweek service streamed live at 7 p.m. And every Friday, we have our prayers at 8 p.m. Every Friday, the month of June. We're going to continue to pray and call unto the name of the Lord.
Because Bible says that those that call unto the name of the Lord, they shall be saved. By the grace of God, 12 noon today, our children are going to interact through Zoom. By the grace of God, 12 noon today. 12 noon. Let your children be a part of it. Let your children be a part of it. 12 noon today, by the grace of God, our children are going to be interacting through Zoom. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. In Jesus' name, we will take our offering at this time.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord for the service today. We thank God for the prayers we have offered. I want us to pray for Pastor at this time. I want us to pray that the Lord will continually anoint him to do his work in the name of Jesus. Let's pray that he will not grow weary. He will not grow tired. Please, I want you to pray for him from the depth of your heart, that the Lord will increase him, that the Lord will touch him more and more in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. It is time for our tithe and our offerings. I want us to read Acts 20:35. It says, in everything I did, I showed you that by this kind of hard work, we must help the weak, remembering the words the Lord Jesus himself said. Remembering the words the Lord Jesus himself said that it is more blessed to give than to receive. It is more blessed to give than to receive. Of course, it is blessed to receive, but the Bible says it is more blessed to give than to receive. Proverbs 11:24 says, one person gives freely, yet gains even more. Says another withholds, but comes to poverty. It is not what you have that will sustain you. The Bible says, cast your bread upon many waters. Cast your bread upon many waters. So this morning, I want you to cast your bread. I want you to give from the bottom of your heart. One person gives freely, yet gains even more. Another withholds, but comes to poverty. There's nothing we have that is not given to us from above. Nothing to our breath. Everything is given to us from above. So I want you to release your offering this morning. Release that seed so that it can go, it can grow and germinate and sow fruits. In the mighty name of Jesus, if you have done that, information to give is also on the screen. If this is your first time, it's displayed on the screen. If you have done that this morning, if you have packaged your tithe, which is your 10% of your increase, I want you to pray to God this morning. I want you to talk to God. I want you to open your mouth and ask the Lord to bless you. Ask the Lord to increase you. It is more blessed to give than to receive. That is what the Bible says. I want you to pray that as you are giving, that you'll be more blessed in the name of Jesus. Don't just give your offering. Don't just give your seeds for nothing. Pray on them. Expect something to happen as you give. It is more blessed to give than to receive. Pray to God that the Lord will bless you, that you'll be more blessed. It is his word. And if you engage it, you're going to see results. So I want you to pray on your seed this morning as you are giving. That, Father, I'll be more blessed according to your word. In everything, I'll be more blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Lord, as your people have given this morning, I pray in the name of Jesus that they will be more blessed according to your word. In the name of Jesus, I decree, O Lord, that every member of our household will be more blessed because we are giving in the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.
Jesus, thank you. We give you the praise. Father, we bless your holy name. I want us to, before we share the grace, I want us to just trust God for what is going on right now, the unrest, and so on and so forth, that God will take control of everything, that Jesus will be glorified in the name of Jesus. That, Father, we commit everything going on in the country, in various cities, oh Lord, that you will be in control. Lord, we ask that you give the leaders wisdom, knowledge, and understanding on how to deal with this situation. Lord, we pray that let your will be done. Lord, let your purpose and your plan, let it be fulfilled in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we ask that let lives not be lost. Lord, especially the ones that will go to hell if they die, that, Lord, you will deliver them, oh God, from hell, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We are asking you, Father, that you will take control of everything, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, you know what is going on. Father, take perfect preeminence of this pandemic all over the world. Let your divine purpose, let it be done. Let your will be done. Let your purpose be fulfilled in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. I just want to release the month of June into the hands of the Lord. Today is the last day of the month of May. Lord, I release the month of June into your hands. That month has 30 days. Let it be the best month, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Let it be a month of joy for people in the name of Jesus. Let it be, let it come with the oil of joy in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray that it will come with the oil of joy. Oh, Father, you will take away every spirit of mourning, oh God, in the name of Jesus. That people will not mourn in the name of Jesus in June, but they will have the oil of joy. We are asking for that oil. Let it rest upon everyone in the mighty name of Jesus. Perfect that month, oh God. Take us through it. Go ahead of us with a pillar of cloud by day and fire by night. In the mighty name of Jesus, we ask that you will make every crooked way straight and every rough road smooth. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we are asking, oh God, concerning the month of June, Lord, that you will lead us, you will guide us, you will carry us on eagle's wings. It will be the best month of our lives. It will be a month of visitation and a month of encounter. Lord, we will seek you. We will come closer to you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you for everything you have done. Take all the glory and all the praise forever and ever. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. And the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit is with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. God be with you. Remember, we have service on Wednesday and Friday. 7 p.m. on Wednesday for midweek service, and Friday is 8 p.m. for prayers, streamed live. And God has answered our prayers in Jesus' name. Have a blessed week. Amen.